While there were illustrators working in movies before these gentlemen, and the science fiction and fantasy worlds of the 1970s and 80s that they helped create, it was during this time that we saw a bigger and more involved role of concept art and design in the film industry. These blockbusters called for fantastical and functional designs, and concept designers became a necessary part of the live-action process. Costumes, vehicles, creatures, futuristic, and alien worlds all required the brains and hands of these artistic individuals. To tell us more about the importance of concept art is costume concept artist Phillip Boutté.
Yes, Phillip Boutté has been working as a costume concept designer, artist, and production designer for film, music video, and television for the past 14 years. He has illustrated for a multitude of blockbuster hits, including Marvel Studios' Black Panther, A Wrinkle in Time, Captain America, Avengers Infinity War, The Justice League, Bohemian Rhapsody, Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, and many more.
Hi, everybody. I'm Phil Boutté. Welcome to the Concept Art Awards, and thank you so much for joining us. I want to talk about concept art. I'm joining you from my office. I want to bare bones talk about what it means to me. Concept art to me represents the initial stab. It's almost like meeting someone for the first time. It's the first impression of what a character, a creature, you know, an environment, a prop, whatever it is, whatever that first initial spark of inspiration, of creativity, of joy can be. And oftentimes, specifically for me as a costume concept artist, I'm trying to find the initial spark of who that person can be, why they wear what they wear, why they are visually represented in the way that they are, and working closely with a costume designer to come up with the vision of what that is. I think that as I move forward, and I've kind of moved forward in my career, I've noticed, you know, some of the greats of and kind of being in little bits of what they do in order to really function as a concept artist. I think concept art is deeply rooted in education. It's rooted in history. It's rooted in knowledge of all things. So it's rooted in really kind of focusing on, in core root, what something is and being able to interpret that back out into the world. An example that I'd like to use is working on Star Trek with costume designer Michael Kaplan. Was one of the first times, I think, in costume that I understood what how things could conceptually work. And that is, in designing Spock's mother. Spock's mother was played by Winona Ryder. There was an instance in where Michael wanted to do a really cool kind of shape on Winona Ryder's chest to kind of limit and kind of create an alien type shape for the Vulcans. And what he told me was, is that throughout history, female costume is basically looked at through the male gaze. So what males find attractive. So it's like accentuating the hips, accentuating, you know, different parts of the body through bustles or corsets or whatever. So what he wanted to do was accentuate what Vulcan men would find attractive. And the thing that they found attractive was the brain, knowledge, right? So he wanted to elongate the neck, soften out the chest, and make it all about the face. Conceptually, that is something that has stuck with me. It's that initial thought of taking something historical and conceptualizing it into a world that we've never been before. It is in the little things. It's watching Charlie Wynn design Kratos on a napkin during his lunch break. It is watching Ryan Meinerding turn in beautiful concept art for Paradise Lost, where you get the juxtaposition between a beautiful angel Lucifer and a hardened, you know, burned Lucifer that falls in his descent into hell. It's those things. It's the strength of those things. It's also, I think, inspiring as we move forward. It inspires change, right? So concept art visually can inspire change. It can be the difference between, you know, looking at a character on the page and everyone visualizing it one way, and then it could be you turning it and flipping it and saying, I'm gonna draw a little Asian girl with dreads, or I'm gonna draw a black woman in a beautiful kimono. It can be those things. And maybe, just maybe, with that change, your director or whoever's looking at these pieces will decide to visualize them in a different way as well. It's inspiring, it is moving forward, it's forward thinking. I think that that's what concept art often means to me. It's establishing the why. why are these things happening? Why is the environment this way? Why is the character wearing what they're wearing? Why did they make that choice? That's what this power of concept art is to me. I think also concept art is about balance. And I think that that's something that a lot of people don't talk about. Concept art is about your balance as a whole. It's balance in life. It's balance in your personal life, your professional life. I think that that's something that trying to constantly marry those things together and being inspired to do so and having that balance is really important. It's Ian McKaig having an open door policy with all of his beautiful drawings, making sure that his family never feels like those two things are separate. That's concept art in a way. It's conceptually thinking about how to live. And it's also your personality, how you present yourself, how you treat people. Concept art is also about that as well. So it's just, it's an overall balance in a life methodology. And I think it's also really focusing on your craft, putting everything you've got into it, consistently learning, you know, learning all of the technology, all of the, you know, the different tools at your disposal, and constantly growing. Research, doing a lot of research. And also lastly, concept art is fun. It should be fun. It's about having a good time. It's about, you know, living your childhood on the screen, presenting something that you really enjoy back out to others. And lastly, I also want to say, just because we've experienced a great loss recently, I want to give a shout out to Mr. Chadwick Boseman, who played Black Panther, and give a salute, Wakanda Forever. Thank you guys for having me so much. And I hope that I was able to express in just a little bit of what concept art means to me and how important it is for us to continue this great tradition. Thank you.